Hello, and today we are with Mr. Roshan Mendis, who's Sabre's Executive Vice President and Chief Commercial Officer, Travel Solutions. Good afternoon to you, Roshan.
Good afternoon, Steve.
Now, here we are. Sabre, it's been an incredible few years for Sabre, but we don't need to talk about COVID just yet. But in terms of the last few months, which a lot has happened for Sabre, one of the most important deals that you've signed recently is with Air India. Why is that such an important deal for the company?
Yes, indeed. We've had a long and storied partnership with Air India for many years. And to get them back in the GDS, participating fully in Sabre, it couldn't come at a better time. Air India is under new management. It has immensely ambitious plans with new orders, new routes, new product. And we are actually coming to the point in the recovery where long-haul travel is very much in vogue after the pandemic, and Air India can use our distribution, we can provide them with valuable customers, and not to mention the solutions that they can avail themselves of that Sabre provides. So we are very pleased to be back in the fold with Air India and looking forward to making this a very productive partnership for both.
Which are some of the key solutions that Air India will be using?
The most notable is our network planning suite. Which comes with our consulting expertise. So as Air India, under its new management, with its new routes and aircraft, think about expanding around the globe as well as domestically, our network planning suite is a software that airlines typically use to position their aircraft in the best route structure to maximize coverage and profitability.
In terms of business volumes, how important is the Indian market currently, and how do you foresee that growing in the years ahead?
Yeah, India is a top three GDS market, also a top travel market in general in and outside of the GDS, and it is the fastest growing GDS market within the top three, so immensely important. It is also a market where Sabre has not had a leadership position historically, and we think with the Air India partnership and a number of other expansion initiatives that are underway, we have the opportunity to participate in a growing market with lots of headroom in front of us in terms of market share.
In terms of segments within the Indian market, because of course it is such a complex market, which when you say that India is in the top three, which segments of the market are growing the fastest?
Actually, all segments are growing very quickly. But the segment that has emerged, not just in India, but around the world, the quickest out of the pandemic has been the leisure and the online travel space. And India is no exception. The managed corporate travel space is quickly catching up. And with India being a hub for commerce in general, but also commerce that allows the Indian businesses to service various businesses globally for call center services, software as we have, and other services, makes it a tourist destination as well as an inbound corporate destination and an immensely large outbound destination.
As you mentioned yourself, Air India has got some very, very ambitious plans. That comes with such a large country, with so many different demographics within that country, it poses a lot of challenges. How does India, in your view, what do they have to do to overcome those? And what role does Sabre play in helping them do that?
Yeah, India is an intensely competitive and complex market in addition to being big. So that has its unique set of challenges. And it's a market that is also growing quickly, which of course strains infrastructure, strains policy and strains airlines and other providers that operate in that space. But the Indian government and businesses that have operated in that space have done a fantastic job over the last couple of decades in coming to this place where it is a top three market for us and the travel market in general. The value that we can bring to Indian operators, if you're an agency or airline in India operating in India, we bring the distribution strength that allows you to access content from around the world, and if you're an airline, to access markets across the world. In addition to that, a number of these strains that I mentioned before can be solved with sophisticated technology. And that is also what we bring to the table for both airlines as well as agency customers.
Now, Air India, of course, and other carriers in India have placed some massive orders for aircraft recently. Air India, I believe, was 470 billion aircraft, or the largest in history. Of course, these aren't going to arrive in a couple of weeks. This isn't an Amazon order. This is going to take a few years for them to get delivered. But how does an airline like Air India prioritize and plan for such a massive number of new fleets to come, new aircraft to come into its fleet?
Yeah, hopefully very thoughtfully, right? But some of these are options, some of these are complex financial structures, and I believe that by the time the full fleet is deployed, it's going to be 2 or 3 years from now. So they are counting on the market expanding, they are counting on flying to destinations that other carriers that are India-based don't have connectivity to, and competing with Middle Eastern carriers and carriers out of Europe and the US that have so ably served the Indian market without Air India flying those routes. But this is the software that we do offer to Air India and other airlines, where the software is able to look at the hubs, look at the origination and destinations, and predict and model where the aircraft should be deployed for maximum effectiveness. Of course, they will be looking at macro trends, micro trends, what tourist hotspots or business hotspots are originations of travelers to India or destinations for India-based travelers. And all of that will be going into the calculus of Air India figuring out how to best deploy this hardware.
Is enough being done as an industry? I mean, if we, for example, CITA just recently said there's more mishandled baggage being happening at the moment. IATA have said that forward bookings are 35% up for the northern summer peak holiday period. Is enough being done in India to A, generate the number of engineers, pilots, crew that these airlines are going to need?
I think people are doing the best they can. We are coming out of the most dislocative event in the history of travel, and you don't unwind from that overnight. So there's billions of dollars of infrastructure projects that are modernizing airports, air traffic control centers, etc., etc. As we've already mentioned, brand new aircraft arriving. And if you've been to India, there are a number of airports, even in the last few years, that have been modernized and made much more luxurious. But there's still more to do. If I look at demand and prices, the traveler is undisturbed by all of this. Prices are at historical highs. Leisure travelers traveling like never before. So I would say that it's a little bit of a game of catch-up as demand surpasses what the infrastructure can handle, then the infrastructure has to catch up. And I think the Indian authorities, as well as the owners and operators of airlines and other travel infrastructure, are doing a reasonable job of making that possible.
Now, of course, distribution, NDC, we're talking more and more about NDC within the industry, and Sabre plays a very important part in this. Where is India in terms of the NDC league, if you were? How advanced are they, and what has to be done to move them forward?
Yeah, I would say Indian carriers have not been at the forefront of pursuing NDC distribution or NDC deals. I would say that in the next 12 to 18 months, you'll see some of the major airlines, Air India being one of them, Indigo being another, scratching at what NDC might mean for them. Of course, Air India was just taken off of the government hands, and it's run in a very sophisticated, technology-intensive manner. And I expect them to be, out of the Indian carriers, first to explore what NDC might mean for them.
What new technology is Sabre working on and developing that will take NDC to the next level? Because of course, with Indian carriers not being quite at the level of some others at the moment, they have the opportunity to possibly leapfrog slightly and jump into the latest technology. What sort of things are you looking at here at Sabre?
Yeah, so the promise of NDC has always been for the airlines to be much more intelligent and responsive in terms of offer generation in relation to who is making the search, who is making the query. That's what the promise of NDC is. And Sabre has been investing along with Google, who we are partners with, in creating technology that enables an airline to identify and price and package smartly in response to those signals that you might get from a traveler searching for travel. And NDC will be the rails through which those offers will be distributed to the traveler or the agency. So NDC forms a vital bit of infrastructure in supporting the software that Sabre has been investing in over the last 2 to 3 years.
A lot of us are talking more about artificial intelligence as well, ChatGPT and all the others. What role do you foresee AI playing in the technology solutions that Sabre offers across the board?
Huge. My imagination is not big enough to think about all the applications of AI in travel, but where we are focused on, along with Google and their vast library of AI capabilities and tools, is to deploy them in our solutions in a smart way that allows at-scale processing of data and finding intelligence that will enable an airline or a hotelier to predict what the best offer is for a traveler to make the propensity to buy the highest. And we have now deployed this technology with a handful of carriers, and it's working marvelously. So we are keen for other airlines to adopt and use NDC rails to deploy this technology and distribute these offers and pricing.
Now, you are in charge of not just the airline sector but also the agency sector. What is the situation in India with the agencies, the OTAs, the travel retail in general? Where is the market at the moment, and how do you foresee that developing as we move forward?
Yeah, similar to the general market, it's a intensely complex and competitive environment. There are mega agencies that are both online and offline. There are OTAs that are incredibly sophisticated and have adapted technology and their offering to the peculiarities of the Indian market. So many of the if not all the large travel agencies in India in the online space are Indian born because they cater to the Indian traveling public. And I expect them to thrive as they cater and build products and customize to the changing needs of the Indian traveler. We have high hopes for the recovery and the continued growth of the indirect channel, which is the agency market in India.
Now, you mentioned earlier increasing airfares, and yet people are still traveling. As I said earlier, IATA has just forecast 35% forward bookings. What is Sabre seeing, and why do you think people are still traveling when airfares are so high and not likely to come down?
Yeah, I mean, there are a few theories, and we watch this space very carefully. One theory is that there's a lot of pent-up demand, a staggering number of dollars that would have been spent on travel during the pandemic that didn't get spent, and we are still unwinding that process of people realizing their travel dreams, whether that be visiting friends and family or going to a unique place or experience. Post-pandemic, people are spending more on experiences versus things, and travel is a fantastic way to experience the world. And travel brings about unique experiences that cannot be replicated doing other activities. Secondly, I think we think that the more flexible work from home policies that have been adopted in many markets allow people to take longer vacations, maybe work a couple of days from an exotic destination and then go on vacation, is creating a different structural dynamic in the leisure marketplace. And if you can take a few more days off, then you're likely to travel further. If you're traveling further, you're likely to take a flight versus drive. So there are a number of factors that are making this post-pandemic recovery a bit different in terms of its structure than it was prior to the pandemic. Of course, there are countervailing forces as well. Prices are high, there are recessionary fears. So we are watching this space very carefully. We try not to make many predictions, just respond and react to the data.
Excellent.
Well, Roshan, I have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today. It always amazes me how quickly these interviews fly, but it's been very interesting to talk to you and learn from you, and I appreciate your time. Thank you very much.
Happy to be with you. Thank you.